All right. Hi. All right. So I'm in my Facebook community group, the Learning with Lauren group, that's had some identity crisis. My oil lady, our Awakened Seed Essence community. It's been an evolution over 5 years. So hello, Zoom room, for anybody who is not on Facebook or other social media that is joining us. I opened up the chat box, so be sure that you can participate in there too. How are you guys doing? I wanted to talk a little bit about winter wellness today. As you know, I'm going to stick with this time Tuesdays at 1 o'clock Arizona time to do some continued education every single week. And so we're going to do it online through the Zoom classroom. I can also stream on our Facebook group or through Instagram, wherever you guys are hanging out. Let me know what is the best platform for that. But the topic today is winter wellness, because it's winter. It's January. Probably in December, most of you have dealt with already the season is upon us. But I noticed a lot of friends and family still really struggling with different things coming up this week, last week, and it's going to continue to move through February. So I wanted to talk a little bit about what is a winter wellness checklist look like. Make sure you have all your bases covered. Make sure you know all the different protocols that you can do for prevention and to support your health as things kind of come up, and make sure you can use the tools that you have, that you try those first before you go into other things. So let's go into it a little bit. One of the things I'm just wondering, I posted about it on Instagram yesterday and haven't gotten a ton of feedback, but a few things. So I'm wondering, why do we get run down in the wintertime? Anybody have any ideas? So we get run down. A couple people replied back to me just because they are stressed, particularly in that December holiday time, people get stressed. Why else do we get run down? We aren't eating properly. We aren't sleeping right. We're not hydrating enough. On that note, I just need a quick drink. We're not moving our bodies as much as we need to. Maybe it's cold and we're not getting outside to do our walking or whatever it might be. So there's a lot of different reasons why our bodies get run down in the wintertime. If you have any other suggestions, just comment in the comment box or in the Zoom chat. So let me know what you think. So some things to be mindful of in the wintertime also, you want to make sure that you're getting enough vitamin D, because perhaps you're not getting as much sunshine exposure because it's winter. Now, it's also it's a season, right? And it's really cool to pay attention to what the energy of seasons is like. So in the wintertime, it's intended on being this kind of like, we get, you know, a little more seclusive, we go inward, it's a darker time of the year, things are slower, not necessarily everything is not, it's not that outward summertime in your face kind of energy. It is a little bit more contracted and slower pace. And so lean into that energy and just embrace it, accept it for what it is. And from that place, so much can be easier. Hi, Jess. So we're talking winter wellness essentials. Like, how is it going for you with wintertime? You know, just the darker season. Like, are you finding that you fight that energy? I think that that is really maybe something that is a reason that contributes to our overall wellness. We all have responsibilities and we live in this world where we kind of like skip over the fact that, you know, we can like take comfort this time of year and sleep a little bit more if wherever and whenever we can, if possible. We lean into those things like warm cup of tea, sitting by a fire, you know, putting on cozy clothes, just little things like that. Is important to just pay attention that this is the season that we're in and that is okay. And because of that, maybe we're not getting enough sunshine exposure. Boost your vitamin D, eat tons and tons, as much as possible, colorful rainbow of vegetables, fruits, really like whole vibrant foods. Those are going to be what is going to boost you the most in getting your foundational nutrition in order. It's an easy time of year to just kind of want to eat things that are like hearty, warm, and filling and comforting in that way. But to really help you, it's important to make sure you're getting those in. And it's not about like what not to eat. It's about just getting a proper amount of those in. Like if you can, 7 to 10 cups of fruits and veggies, fresh ones if possible. Another thing to make sure that's on your checklist is On Guard. On Guard, On Guard. Like diffuse it every day, put it on the bottoms of your feet, roll it on the back of your neck. Take capsules when you feel like you need extra support. On Guard all the time. Hey, Sonia, how are you? Good to see you around. What's new? It's been a long time. So let's see. We're talking a little bit more about all the things we need to have on our checklist. Proper supplementation. So are you taking some kind of additional supplementation to make sure you're getting those nutrients in? I did say vitamin D just separately because you might want to boost that in the wintertime. Thorne brand has a really good one that's also like K3 is added into that. Or I'm not sure if Vimergy is a company that I order sometimes individual supplements, like extra B12. I love theirs too. So B12 is a good one to just, D and B12, a lot of times people are deficient, to have a little extra boost of that. So proper supplementation is super important. Make sure that you're washing your hands a ton. And if you have not gotten On Guard hand soap, or the Holiday Peace one was really nice over the winter, but if you have not gotten the On Guard hand soap, it's amazing. It's probably like our favorite thing in the house that everybody is just a big fan of. And it's just, it doesn't leave your hands super dry. It keeps them moisturized. It smells so good. And it makes me feel so good that my kids can come home from school and they're like boosting their immune systems and washing all the gunk off of their hands. So make sure you have that on hand. Tell me what else you guys might be struggling with. We're going to go over some specific protocols for when things do come up in wintertime to make sure you know how to use your oils. So with basically like the beginner's kit. So anything in particular, pop it into the comments, into the chat box, like what's coming up for you in winter? What are you struggling with? So I can make sure to touch on it. But I got a little bit of feedback through my Instagram post I was saying. So we're going to go over cold and flu. We're going to go over sinuses. We're going to go over tummy. We're going to go over, sleep, stress. And I think there might be one other thing. We'll see what else. So if there's anything else that I'm leaving out, just please pop it into the comments. All right, so make sure also that you are getting proper sleep. So like seven and a half hours like is ideal for your body, unless you happen to know that like without using an alarm clock that you are just a person who requires less sleep. Then you feel rested and you only need like 5 or 6 hours. Like there are some people like that out there. I personally need my full 7.5 hours of sleep. And in the winter time, for some reason, it's just, I need a little bit more, and that you just have to respect that. So make sure you're just making time for it, you know, cut things out so that you go to bed a little bit earlier, or that you can adjust your maybe wake up time. It's okay to do that in the winter time. Make sure you're drinking a lot of water. And I've been adding all winter long lemon juice and lemon essential oil in my water in the morning. So when I wake up, the first thing that I do, first thing right away, is hydrate with at least 16 to 20 ounces of water with like a half of a lemon juiced into it and one drop of essential oil, whether it be lemon, orange, tangerine is really nice, lime, a nice citrusy water in the morning. You can have it warm, you can have it hot, you can have it cold. But just get it in your body first thing. It's amazing for how well it's going to help flush out your body, your system. It's going to properly hydrate you. And if by adding the squeeze of lemon juice, you're getting some extra vitamin C. So we also want to, along with hydrating, we want to make sure we're moving our bodies. It's easy in the wintertime to avoid this process. Like we're not getting out with like natural maybe exercise as much. If you live here in Arizona, maybe you're still hiking or getting outdoors because it's it's decent weather out. It's pretty nice in the afternoons. This maybe some of you think it's nice in the morning. I am just that wimp who's lived here for a really long time and I still think it's too cold. I'm like freezing in the morning. So whereas other parts of the year, I'm like up early, we're out walking the dog, like at sunrise, like I'm doing yoga by the pool. It's great. But for right now, like I'm an afternoon getting outside kind of girl. But make sure that that doesn't compromise how much you're moving your body. So at least a little walk in your day. If that's not happening, get yourself to a gym where it's warmer. A hot yoga studio is what I've been leaning into. I love me that heat and moisture while it's so cold and dry. It's amazing. Check it out. So I've been going to, if you live around here, Inner Vision lately. There's several locations. There's One Tribe Yoga. If you are athletic and really enjoy a rigorous workout, that place is for you. It's a beautiful place. There's, of course, like lots and lots of hot yoga studios around, but those are the ones that I love lately. So if you want to join me for practice sometime, that'd be fun. Hey, Shannon, how are you? Been a long time. Say hi, say what's up for you this winter. I'm getting to some protocols, I promise, but I just want to make sure you have like this mindset of a checklist of lifestyle type things that you can do to be preventative and to support your health in the winter. Make sure that along with exercise, so whether it's, you know, walking, there you're going to any type of a fitness class, something like that, that you are also thinking about that this is serving as a way to cleanse your body. So sweating is super important. You want to make sure that your body gets a chance to sweat and cleanse out things. So, and getting your cardiovascular system going and that heavy breathing going, really important part of it. We're going to talk a little bit more about some other ways that you can assist your body in cleansing with oils too. So I'll get to that point. Then, let's see, I think that's the last thing. Just practice relaxing as much as possible. And like I said, leaning into the season. There is kind of an art to appreciating winter, and that will really help to protect your nervous system and your immune system this time of year. So use this as a time to kind of be inward, be thinking about all the things that you're going to be more outwardly expressive of as the year moves on. But for now, if things do come up, let's talk about, we know how great these oils are. So that flu and cold stuff that's really going around, that viral stuff that's going around, it lingers, right? So, and it kind of has like, it seems like in our area, it starts out like a bit of head tension, and then it moves into like sinus pressure and congestion up in here behind the ears. And then it starts to be really like clogged up. We can't breathe. And then it starts to almost like drip as the day goes on. So by the nighttime, we have this like itchy coughing thing, having a hard time breathing, and it just kind of gets persistent and persistent. And then if those airways can't stay clear and fluid, then a lot of times they'll get, they can become a real problem, really impacted or infectious, and that type of stuff gets really nasty. So important thing to do is to right away at the first sign, do those lifestyle things and adapt and right away as much as you can. You need to slow it down, hydrate, rest, get cozy, eat the right things, and then you can start to use some essential oils. So for me, what I was doing at first was just like a little bit of peppermint when I would notice some of that head tension coming on. Our family got hit with it like right before Christmas time. And then it tended to like, it moved into two of us out of four. And my son and I were able to stay away from it. I just had a little bit of like, I knew I was overdoing it and had started to get some of the head tension and really just needed some peppermint. I took some On Guard capsules for a couple of days. So if you don't have these On Guard capsules, this is like a staple you got to have on board. This has all of the On Guard oils in it with a boost of black pepper and Melissa. So it's super powerful, but you can also make your own capsules. So I'm going to give you the flu balm, because if it does come down to that, you're starting to feel like it's coming on, or somebody in your house has it already and you want to know how you can help them alleviate it. So first thing I would do, sorry, you guys, I'm getting an incoming call and forgot to put my do not disturb on. Let me see. Are we still good? If anybody's still with me, let me know. I'm going to try to go through this as quick as I can. So thank you for hanging there with me. But the flu bomb, you can do a roller in a 10 mil roller. You can do 8 drops each of frankincense, tea tree, oregano, lemon, and peppermint. So you can do 8 drops each of those and top it off with the carrier oil, fractionated coconut oil, avocado oil, or whatever. Or you can do maybe 3 drops total in a veggie cap. So one of frank, one of en garde, one of oregano, I would say, is probably the most that that you would want to do in one capsule at a time. You could also, like, you know, put in some lemon or add that in another dosage. Okay, it's saying poor connection. Let me just take a quick drink and see if it comes back. You guys okay? It like froze for a second, I think, but I think we're okay. So that's the flu bomb. I love that. So you can use it in a capsule. You can use it topically. So what we did with like a roller is just kind of take it up behind the ears, down the throat, and you guys, like, up into the sinus area. Another thing, if there's a lot of pressure and congestion, that peppermint is great, but you can also use Digestin. Really helps to kind of break up and digest the mucus. For whatever reason, that seems to work really well. So we just have a Digestin roller, kind of like roll it around here. You know, just use them frequently. That is the most important thing. Like, you need to remember that you have to control your dosage, that you've got to keep a few things nearby with you and use it about 5-6 times or more throughout the day, especially if it's well diluted topically. You know, putting things on the bottoms of your feet, just that blend on the bottoms of your feet or any one of those oils, but I suggest all of them for sure along the spine. So for kiddos, make sure you're diluting things properly. If you have specific questions about like who and what, don't hesitate to post it as it comes up over winter, maybe below this video, so I can help guide you with some specifics on that. But I think you've got the gist of it there. And then let's say it involves more of like tummy discomfort. You kind of lean into that Digestin for the tummy discomfort, and you can use some wild orange with that. It's really nice. It's also a helpful tummy soother. If you wanted to make a roller, it's about 40 drops total of Digestin. Top it off with coconut oil, or buy the pre-diluted touch roller, or you can also do like 20 drops of that plus wild orange. And there's a new kiddo one called Tamer that is a really nice choice. It's a little bit more spearminty, a little milder for kiddos. That would be a really good choice. And then with any type of tummy stuff, it's typically very viral. So I always add oregano and melaleuca to the feet. So tea tree and oregano to the feet. Along with all of this stuff, aromatic baths are a really great idea. So for stress, for sleep, for any of this cold and flu viral junk, put some lavender, some tea tree, some frankincense, and some Epsom salt. So you want to take about, like, if it's for a child, half a cup, for an adult, a cup of Epsom salt. You can add a little bit of coconut oil in there if you want to. You just want to disperse your essential oils in something, into the salt, into oil, into baking soda, and then add it to your bath to soak in. And it does wonders for knocking out whatever it is that's going on imbalanced in your body, and just takes your nervous system into a great reset too. So I would add that in with any of those things. Now, I posted also yesterday the sinus balm, I guess we can call it, sinus remedy. I saw this from a functional medicine doctor years ago when I first started, and it is something I go to all the time. It's 4 oils: oregano, melaleuca, tea tree, which is your melaleuca. So oregano, tea tree, lemon, and peppermint, a drop each. And you put them into, like, boil some water, put them into a hot cup, or you can use like a big like glass or metal bowl, and in the cup, and you just kind of cup your hands around your nose and your mouth and breathe it in. And you can hold it in as long as you can do that for at least like 5 or 10 minutes. Just keep breathing it in. It will just clear out all of that congestion. So you know, if you're having to function and that type of thing, using your roll-ons like DigestSun is great. But if you just really want to hit it hard, try it, or at the end of the day before it gets really uncomfortable to sleep, try to do that. Or you can do it over a big bowl with like a towel over your head. That works wonders for, it's like this natural expectorant kind of thing going on. Has anybody ever tried that? I've probably done videos on here before, but it really, really helps. So let me know if you've tried it before, if you like that one. The other thing that I think is magic is also making like your own cough syrup. So you take a teaspoon of raw honey and add one drop of frankincense, one drop of On Guard, and one drop of lemon right to it. And it's just this like natural cough syrup. You can also make up like a big batch of it if you're all kind of struggling with something. It just coats the throat. You could add it to tea. It does a really good job at coating the throat and helping to alleviate that persistent tickle. A lot of times with all this same stuff, the ears are hard airways to keep clear with that drainage. So it's all connected. And I know when I was a younger mom with my kids, the ears were like just the worst thing to deal with, because it would always happen in the middle of the night with like a loud cry, just terrible. And you'd end up having to kind of like sleep sitting up all night with your child or something like that. So when I found this working instantly, this was one of the things I was like, I can't not talk to other moms about this. This like changed the game for me, because my daughter would always, as soon as she had like a little bit of a sniffle, it always went to the ears. So you use Melaleuca, lavender, and basil. Gotta have these oils on hand, you guys, over the winter, because if you don't have it on hand, you know, you're going to be running out to CVS and end up on some Tamiflu or like some other kind of cough medicine or whatever. But like, I promise you, if you just have this stuff on hand and you just try it with a little bit of like consistency and a little bit of patience, like you're going to feel better and you're going to help everybody improve within your home so much faster than all that. You're not going to waste any of your money because you have this stuff. Remember when we first met, I didn't want you buying anything you weren't going to use. So just great that you're here taking some time to know how to use it. So how you would do that for the ears, I like to layer this one. So even if you can make it a roller if you want to, but I like to just take a drop or two and you can put it in coconut oil in your hand for a kiddo, or you can just rub it straight behind the ear, like right along the back of the ear, kind of along the jaw, and start with the lavender, the tea tree behind the ear, and then you can work in a little bit of basil. You can also take a small piece of a cotton ball and put a drop of basil right on there and just pop it into the ear. Never put oil straight into your ear, guys. Remember, not into the ears, not into the eyes, any other orifices of the body where there's like mucous membranes and things like that. So you just set it into the ear gently. You can even put a little piece of medical tape over it, or just have them like a child lay down and then, you know, keep the side propped up so that it just gently works its way into the mucous membranes of the ear. It helps to keep everything so clear, and it's instantly very soothing. Sometimes if there's a lot of pain, I've added a little bit of grapefruit, and that just kind of takes away some of the pain for some reason. It just adds that purifying aspect, I suppose. And speaking of that, Purify is another oil that has worked for some people. This other blend is what works best for me. So that's what we use. And then finally, I just wanted to share, like, anybody have trouble turning off the mind to go to sleep a little earlier? I know after transitioning after break, kids getting back into school last week, like the new year, and with that, like there's this freshness and renewal, and like we've gotten a little bit of rest, but at the same time, it's like hard to just get into that like work mode again or back to school. Like it's, everybody's still dragging a little bit. At least we were last week, having a harder time being in our routine. So at going to bed a little earlier and getting like the chatter of all the things that are just like exciting within the mind to do has been hard. So here's an awesome diffuser blend that you can use, or you can make it into a roller that you put on the back of your neck, bottoms of your feet, pulse points before bed. Works beautifully. So in a roller, it's 15 drops of magnolia. So magnolia is sold in a roller. already right now, but you can just take off the little tops. This is just a digest send one that I made, but you can just take off these little tops. So easy, you guys. You can buy these six of them for $4.75 in your back office, virtual store, I mean. And then they also sell pipelets. You can take the oil out from the magnolia diluted and just do 15 drops of that into your sleep roller. Along with that, you're going to add 7 drops of cedarwood, 5 drops of wild orange, and 7 drops of balance. That is such a beautiful turn the chatter off blend. And then you can do some variation of that in your diffuser that's a little bit higher in magnolia, or you could just do the magnolia on topically in your roller if that's what you have, and apply balance, wild orange, and cedarwood into your diffuser if you wanted for some ease. Another one, if like you just struggle, of course, like any of those oils on them on their own are going to be helpful in your diffuser or on topically, like magnolia, frankincense, lavender, serenity. I love the serenity capsules, the capsules with the oil in your diffuser. So you take a capsule like when you're starting your bedtime routine, and then put some serenity into your diffuser. I mean, that's like such an easy, great way to get a solid 7.5 hours of uninterrupted sleep. But balance, orange, cedarwood, vetiver, those are all great choices for bedtime. Another liquid sleep roller combo that I use and like is 15 drops of lavender, 10 drops of vetiver, and then 5 drops of frankincense, 5 drops of ylang ylang, and 5 drops of wild orange. For some reason, wild orange is like in a lot of these recipes because it does help to kind of like keep you asleep. So if that's something that you haven't tried, maybe give that a go. So we've talked about resting more, all those little things that might come up that you need your recipes for, go use them. And then, like I said, along with your good eating habits, try to get in some ways of flushing it out. So like citruses in your water, try the Zendocrine essential oil blend. So it's the detoxifying blend. You can add a drop of that to water. There are capsules of it too. If you want to just add that into your morning flush it out routine, you can take a capsule of that, or you can just use the oil blend itself, dilute it, rub it onto your organs, your kidneys, your liver, you know, and just use like maybe a warm compress at the end of the day, just to kind of ease everything is really nice. You can even add a drop or two of it into a bath. It does have a little bit of some citruses in it, but it's never been anything that, as long as I dilute it well or disperse it in salt, that's ever been irritating. It's a nice way to flush out your body as well. There are also, of course, other supplements that you might want to look at. If you haven't looked at the cleanse protocol, that is a really good way to reset your body. After, you know, the holidays, not only do we tend to like eat differently, drink differently, like all those things that we need to flush out of our bodies, but there's a lot of stress that accumulates and a lot of emotions, and your organs all have memory of that. So it's very important to just kind of like see what's going on with yourself and let things go as you move into this new year. Do a little bit of extra time with yourself and journaling and learning how to meditate. I'm here for you. All of this type of work is super important. You want to stay in your best spirits, your best energy as much as possible through positivity, through all kinds of different techniques that are out there. One of the things that I've been doing is a challenge every day. There's a little email and something that comes about just like helping you to stay within alignment with that sort of positive, high vibrational energy and focusing on what is really thriving and being in that alignment with what you're grateful for every day. That is so important to helping you stay well also, because when you're in alignment, you're in that good energy, you tend to just kind of deflect all the things that are negative, including like the gunk that goes around at wintertime, and you're more in tune with paying attention to the things that are going to serve you in your day. So I hope this wasn't too lengthy. Thank you for popping in. And thanks for saying hi, those of you who said hello. And I look forward to seeing you guys again at this time next week. We're going to be talking about more of the detoxifying your system. This is going to be a little bit more in depth on what I do with my food, with all those colorful fruits and veggies to help you detoxify your system. And then some other, of course, mind, emotional, body stuff that we're going to talk about as well for detoxifying your system next week. If you have any other questions as the winter goes on, please post it here. And thanks. I will see you soon. Is there any other little things that I forgot to tell you? If you happen to be in Chandler, I am going to do a version of this class in person tomorrow at Civic Market, downtown Chandler. So come and check it out. Come say hi to me. Come hang out, have a cup of tea, have an appetizer, something like that at 6:30, just for a brief 30, 45 minutes or so. I can teach you. We can make some rollers. Just give me a heads up that you're coming and what you might need. And I'd be happy to help you with any of those things that you might be missing. So thanks, you guys. Enjoy yourselves. Stay well. Bye. And ending over here. Thank you.